Hello and welcome to the Pan Am Cup 2013 Men's Edition. We're here in Brampton, Ontario. The first game is Argentina versus Mexico. Teams are walking out right now. Beautiful sunny morning here in Brampton. We're going to have the national anthem soon and then we'll get right to the hockey. I'm joined at the tower here with Ali Lee, former Canadian international. We're going to be bringing you all the games live streamed from Brampton, 20 games in total, and at the end, here's the national anthem for Argentina.
Thank you.
We're almost ready to go here. Teams are shaking hands at the center line, Argentina for Mexico, the opening game of the men's 2013 Pan Am Cup. We're at a brand new facility here in Brampton. First hockey facility, hockey-only facility built in Toronto for the last 20 years. Ali, what do you think about the setup here?
Well, I know the crews here have been working many days and working and planning for the last few months, and the facility looks absolutely fantastic. We have a great view from up in the tower here. Stands are starting to fill, and it looks like it's going to be a beautiful day here in Brampton.
Well, that is certainly true. Argentina, the top-ranked team in this tournament from a world ranking standpoint. It's a tough opening game for Mexico. Argentina having just come from the World League semifinals, which is the primary way to qualify for the World Cup. Of course, here at the Pan Am Cup, one team will be determined from the Pan American region to qualify for the World Cup next year. Argentina looks like the favorite, don't they?
Yeah, I mean, absolutely. We look down the roster here, and Argentina has seven people capped over with over 100 caps, and Mexico only has 11 players total that are capped. So definitely an experienced side here Argentina brought, and I think it'll be a good challenge for Mexico, but I definitely look forward to seeing how this plays out.
Great. The teams are almost ready. Mexico in the south end of the field, defending the south end of the field, Argentina in the north end. Looks like Argentina has the pushback. Lucas Vila, one of their most experienced players, over the ball right now. Argentina starts. The play moves across the midfield. Across the back, Argentina's gonna play the ball left and right across the back here, looking for openings. Mexico, their full team in their defending half, trying to contain any early pressure by Argentina. There's a through ball into space. Pedraza for Mexico turns and plays it back. Argentina starting to put some pressure on now, forcing a mistake and a lost ball turnover. Argentina turns and they start to attack. Oh, an early chance at a goal, wow. A reverse stick cross, and who's the goal scorer? Ali, do you see who that was?
I think it's number 10. I can't see. He's celebrating with all his fans there, but definitely definitely taking advantage of the quick free hit off the inbound there in the corner, just catching Mexico a little bit on their heels.
Yeah, it was Mateus Paredes. That's the most capped player for Argentina, 223 games, and he scores a goal in his 224th. Argentina up early. I think that was the second minute. The ball came coming off the Mexican goalkeeper. And Paredes is there to capitalize. Argentina doesn't look like they're going to wait to try to score their second goal here. Already on the attack. Lopez up the right side. Across. That is collected well. And again, it's Pedraza able to man the forward at the back and gain a free hit for Mexico. Continued pressure by Argentina here. Mexico trying the aerial ball to get out of trouble. Argentina collects that, and here we go. They switch the ball right to left to look for an opening there. It's tough when a team packs the defense like this in order to try to, you know, stymie a stronger opposition. What's your thought on that tactic this early in a game for Mexico?
Well, it's definitely challenging, but as you can see, the Argentinian backline has really stepped into their own 50 trying to make space in behind there.
There was another cross there. It's very difficult for defenders to manage those reverse stick crosses. They generate a lot of power and are hard to defend. In fact, that ball went off one of our umpires. I think that was Galvin Caldicott in that end. Oh, and a quick free hit again, catching Mexico on their flat feet, and another goal.
Just a loose ball there, and he just took that ball right out of the air and fired it home. I don't think the keeper was quite ready.
Well, it looks like Argentina is on form, having come from playing probably a higher level competition in Malaysia, and Mexico not quite ready for this opening game. 2-0, 4 minutes into the match.
And I think that actually came from a defender, so you can see where that attack comes from, right from their backfield overlapping into the circle.
Right, a team experienced like Argentina will interchange like that, and it's not as if anybody's stuck in one position. And there we go, another goal, 3-0 Argentina. This time a driving, not really a cross, but a driving shot into the circle and a deflection from the left wing. And really, we've got some sun in our eyes here, so we're trying to figure out who these numbers are.
I think that's Tione, number 7 there.
Cayoni out on the left wing, overlapping and able to get his reverse stick touch on that. Oscar Hernandez, the Mexican captain, is going to have to regroup his team here, but Argentina doesn't want to give them any space. Another chance. Oh, my God, it's another goal.
Nice little give and go there from Paredes. Just really calm in the circle there to find the winger coming in.
So the Argentinian experience really coming through here. We have Moises Vargas in the Mexican goal. He's 90 caps for Mexico. That's probably one of their most experienced players, but he's finding it difficult with the multiple attackers from Argentina.
Absolutely. You can see just the basics breaking down here. The Argentinian pressure is just a little bit too much for the Mexican team to handle right now.
Yeah, you can see of the 22 players on the pitch, a good 19 of them are in the attacking zone. Attacking half, that is.
And again, you see Lopez there overlapping right into the circle, just even passing the forward line there to try and gain some momentum.
Yeah, and he's what you would call a midfielder. Here's the first attack for Mexico up the right-hand side. Good work there. Aguilar, one of the more experienced Mexican players, he's really attacking on his own, one on three, but he gets a free hit and allows his team to move up the field and support him. So Mexico will be looking to gain possession up at the Argentinian end and then try to manufacture an attempt at the circle. A push into the circle, but two Argentinians waiting to clear it. And Mexico with a little errant attempt moving forward. Maybe they have another chance to trap Argentina in their end. Let's see if Mexico will press as much or even at all compared to Argentina.
Seems like they're just backing up into a three-quarter and almost a half-court press here. They're just letting Argentina come out, trying to defend a smaller space, it seems.
Well, when your opposition is stronger, you rather have the game smaller.
Absolutely.
I think they know if they try to spread out and put pressure in the Argentinian end, they have a lot of options, Argentina. Well, all teams do. They can play the ball in an aerial fashion, and some of these players can scoop the ball 60 yards overhead. And they can also hit the ball through many defenders depending on the skill level. So Mexico will have to be worried about, be careful if they try to advance forward too much. Here's a break. We have a Bobadilla attacking one-on-one on Piat. He gains a free hit there. Mexico just outside the Argentinian circle. Miguel Leon passes it across. They're moving the ball to the right-hand side, trying to find a gap in the Argentinian defense. Across, collected by Gallardi. And very good skills there. Very good skills. Mateus Rey has no problem turning the Mexican pressure inside out and gaining a free hit.
Yeah, you just see that patience coming out of their backfield. Mexico struggling a bit under the pressure here, but definitely gaining some forward action here. And you can see how this game really is a game of errors.
Yeah, and the top level players, they don't make as many errors, and they can take advantage of some of the commitments that the other players make. The Mexicans will maybe be a bit more desperate to make a tackle, to make an interception, and Argentina will be quick to take advantage of it.
Pedraza doing a really good job cleaning up at the top of the circle there.
Yes, he is, but his pass inside is errant, and we have a chance for Argentina. No, it's whistled against him. It might have hit his foot there. Caldecott making that call. Mexico start up again. They get the ball in there on top of their circle. They don't seem to make any options. Now they leak one out to the right-hand side here. But it's lost at the center line. Mateus Rey over the ball, and he'll switch it up to the right-hand side. Gilardi. There's the overhead ball we were talking about. Lopez on the run. Can't quite corral it. This is the first game for these players on a new turf. It's a high bounce. He was unable to collect that, Ali, a new turf, does it play any different than, let's say, a seasoned pitch that's been on the ground for 6 to 8 months and a lot of games played on it?
Yeah, absolutely. This pitch is a little bit bouncy. I know the players were practicing on it for the last 2 days, and the bounce is quite a bit. It's going to depend on how much water. Of course, the sun here evaporating a lot of that water, so we'll see what they make of it.
Early in the day today, so the watering system is probably pretty good right now. They'll water at halftime to make sure the ball and the sticks can move freely on this artificial grass surface. Argentina in command. 9 minutes into the match. Mexico happily trying to just get the ball to the halfway line and get possession. Bobadilla, there's a good through ball. Aguilar looking to the right. His player's covered there. Oh, and he's been tripped up a little bit. Legal play by Argentina. And Ibarra slows the game down a little bit, maintains possession. There's some experience showing, and they're happy to play the ball back. Gilardi out to Lopez. Good inside move there. Commitment by Bobadilla. Nice pass. Mexico looking for a foul there. They put their hands up to say that something might have happened wrong there, but the umpire did not indicate a foul. Argentinian free hit on the right, left-hand side.
You can see all 11 players of Argentina now were in that attacking half. Just getting a little bit more comfortable to press up and take advantage of right to that baseline.
Well, we're in a format which is two pools of four here, and Argentina typically in these tournaments they really stand tall and they win their pools by a significant margin. So they're not too worried about a goal difference, but they don't want to get complacent and not really put away these teams early so they can save their energy for final games. But Mexico, they might be thinking about how many goals get scored against them, because it'll make a difference to who finishes second place in the pool, which allows you a semifinal opportunity. So what is their strategy now to try to contain Argentina and not let them run away with this game?
Well, I think with Argentina's experience, it's tough to come out in the opening minutes of a game. But for them, I think just moments like that, capitalizing on their unforced errors and, just maintaining possession and trying to do the simple things in their defensive end right.
And it's difficult when you have all these blue shirts surrounding you to do the right thing. They're, as you said, it's a game of errors, and your opposition will force you to make errors more often than not. Lucas Villa twisting and turning in the offensive end. This switching forces Mexico to move across the pitch, and hopefully that's what Argentina is looking for, some exposed gaps. Juan Martin Lopez taking a quick self-pass. You no longer have to pass the ball to your teammate when there's a whistle. You can quickly move the ball on. It's allowed hockey to move much quicker. Ali, was this a rule in place? You just retired a year and a half ago. What do you see now? It's very different, isn't it?
It's definitely opened up the game, particularly around the circle, as you saw in their very first goal.
Chance at goal there. Vargas making a couple saves before it went off an Argentinian foot. It's a little better defensive play by Mexico. That's probably the first real chance that Argentina's had that Mexico's managed to thwart. The ball rolls here, and Vivaldi in the Argentinian goal hasn't had to play a ball yet. Let that one roll through for a 16-yard hit.
We just saw some really fancy stick work from Aguilar from Mexico there. Really seems to be the person that's really causing the most trouble up front for Mexico.
Yeah, Bobadilla has been very good in the midfield, Aguilar, but it seems that they're attacking alone.
Absolutely.
That ball was off an Argentinian foot, but they play advantage here. Argentina's happy to move the ball along. Great ball speed as the ball's crossed over to Gagliardi. Mexico having trouble clearing, running the ball out of play, and a little errant pass there. Goes off Gilardi's foot. It's a bit of a break for Mexico. Argentina intercepting at the half. Oh, nice little behind-the-back pass. Lopez running up the right-hand side. Will he try to enter the circle himself? He does, looking for a foot perhaps off Ortega. Gets the sideline hit instead, a long corner. Self-pass again. Now we have a cross. That's kicked out by Vargas and unable to control the rebound is Lucas Rey. That ball goes high, deemed dangerous, and Mexico will start up again.
And I think Barrera was looking for a call from Gavin Caldicott there for the high ball off the keeper's pad, but I think the umpire decided that he was able to play that, and he did that unsafely.
Yeah, they've changed that danger rule. It's a small ball. It hurts when you get hit by it for sure, but they've changed that danger rule so that they're not calling things that are in the air automatically dangerous. If it's in a space, it's away from a player, it's acceptable. And it's really sped up the game. A large number of rule changes to speed up the game to make it far more spectator-friendly.
Some great individual stick work there.
Yeah, Balareos dribbling up the right-hand side. Shot on goal. Well saved and cleared, but Argentina, or Mexico, not able to get any pressure in the midfield, and they move it on. Ortiz moving the ball to the far left. There's a good tackle. But great pursuit by Argentina, slows up the play. Mexico having to move back, and now they've lost it to Lopez. Great pass to the middle. Aguilero in the circle, now out, plays it wide. Lopez looking for a foot, perhaps. Good pass, and saved by Vargas. Mexico clears, but not out. Argentina continue to attack up the right-hand side. Maintain the pressure and intercept again. It's an even number of green and blue shirts in there, but Argentina seems to have the advantage. They maintain possession and gain a free hit. Gilardi crosses. Stopped by Salas, and he exits the circle, only to lose it at the 25. Aguilar spinning. Almost enters the circle. Probably had some space to his right. Chose to pass instead. Pedraza now with the ball. Good attack here. Ball moves to the center. Mexico has it. Oh, we're getting our first penalty corner of the game. Mexico trying to clear the ball. Bobadilla puts it off his own player's foot. Penalty corner for Argentina.
You just really see the speed of Argentina there. They just kind of come in waves, and as soon as the whistle blows, they're taking their free hit before Mexico even knows what's happening, and I think that's really playing into their advantage.
Yeah, Argentina was here a bit earlier, perhaps, in Mexico. The time it takes with the time difference or the flight, they're clearly a superior team. Mexico looking a little slow to start. Penalty corner where the teams have 45 seconds to inject the ball from the baseline. Mexico with five defenders here. Oh, great save. Chicken Dance with the penalty corner drag flick. He's their specialist, but on the line a save. Did you get a number for that player?
No.
Argentina not slowing up, though. There's another cross. Saved by Vargas, and that went off an Argentinian foot. The ball clears out. Mexico, oh, they get trapped up quickly. They were trying to do a quick counterattack up the right-hand side, but really well recovering was Argentina, led by Salas.
And that's a pretty lethal corner unit to be defending against, so a really well-saved ball there on the post.
Argentina's known over the years to have a great penalty corner drag flicker. They finished second in that World League Round 3 tournament to Germany. Germany, you know, of course, the Olympic champions right now, so finishing second there was a tremendous achievement. And so they come here. They've come with a strong team, though. They come with a very strong team for the Americas tournament. None of their key players are missing, and that was indicated in that 4-0 start. Mexico again happy to retreat to a, what did you call it, a three-quarter press?
Well, it's looking more and more like a half-court press now as they're all in their own 50. But Argentina doing so well, getting in behind them.
Yeah, well, that was a very long, that was a 40-yard pass deep into the Mexican area, and despite having all their players in the one half, they're unable to stop that channel, and a great opportunity now again for Argentina. Penalty corner. It was Lucas Vila. He received that long pass earlier. Another penalty corner for Argentina. It's interesting, that left-hand attacking side used to be a very bad place to be as a forward. But with this, the new reverse stick kind of shooting they're able to do and these great skills these players have, it's now not a bad place to attack the goal from.
Yeah, absolutely. I think especially with their lifted skills along the baseline there, the defense can't get caught flat-footed and expose their feet. They really have to keep their feet moving and rely on the goalkeeper to come out.
All right, Chicken Dance with his second chance at it. Let's see if Argentina goes for the straight option. Bit of a misplay at the top of the circle, and they hit it. Good save by Vargas, and Mexico is able to clear. The hit option on the penalty corner is not used anywhere near as often as it used to be, Ali.
Yeah, that's right. Definitely the drag flick, especially in men's hockey, is your go-to with the speed of the ball and on the turf.
Yeah, you find it on the men's side that every team has a specialist, and on the women's side, only about half the top teams are consistently using the drag flick, but on the men's side, it's probably 90%.
And at that top level, that really does make the difference. Sometimes the game comes down to one or two penalty corners.
Yeah, and we saw that save at by the postman for the Mexican team. They've added more equipment, so that is far more possible than it used to be.
Yeah, it definitely makes your job a little bit easier knowing that your body's a bit more protected in the face and on your hands.
So they have face masks and gloves, small cricket gloves that allow you to play the ball with a little less fear, and that certainly helps the goaltenders out and has reduced the number of penalty corners that are often considered automatic goals for some teams.
It's pretty hard to react, so having a mask on your face can save a lot of we've seen a lot of broken bones, broken face bones over the years, so that technology has definitely advanced the game as well.
Well, I must say that the FIH, the International Governing Body for Field Hockey, has been very good. They make rule changes often. Some people say too often. Oh, here's a chance for Argentina. Very quickly from the center line. It's two passes later. And we have another goal. 5-0 Argentina.
That goal coming from Barrero. Again, Paredes setting that up. Just a great distributor with his head on a swivel there to find the open man on the right side there.
Yeah, you can see the way he receives the ball. The ball's coming from behind him. He collects it, and his head is up, and he's moving forward, and he finds the open man. 5-0, Argentina, well in control of this game. We have 14 minutes to play in the first half.
We did see a bit of a break between the fourth goal and the fifth goal. I think they're just settling in a bit, and Mexico's tightening up in the backfield as much as they can.
Yeah, for a stronger team like Argentina, they're very happy to go with that early lead. They don't want to keep the game close for very long. It gives lower ranked teams a sense that they might have a chance to win, but they did their job in the first 5-10 minutes, and now they're going to control the rest of this game. But you're right, Mexico has been sharper. They've had some attacks, and I think they'll be very happy if they manage to convert one of their chances.
Credit to Vargas in goal there, making a couple great saves.
He has. He'll have to make one here. He does. Comes out, makes that save. The reverse stick shot. He smothers that as well. But no, Gavin called a penalty stroke. Not sure why that happened. That was a bit of a blocked viewpoint for us. But Vargas making two saves. And he may have, as he was on the ground, hit the attacker's stick with his own stick. Ignacio Ortiz was attacking there. So a penalty stroke, one shot from 7 yards away from the goal. Definitely an advantage for the attacker, Ellie.
Absolutely. I can't see him making too many mistakes here. And he doesn't.
Lucas Villa makes it. 6-0 Argentina. A high glove side penalty stroke.
Those are pretty hard to save.
Hey, I played in goal for many years. Vargas goes the right way. He still isn't able to make the save. And so goaltenders often guess one way or the other. And even if you guess the right way, it's still difficult to make some contact with the ball.
I think especially on that side without the extra 36.5 inches of your stick.
Yeah, the stick certainly extends your range, but it's a hard thing to wield. The glove is a bit easier to save with. But that shot was very close to the post and difficult to save. Mazzilli with a little bobble on his left side. Mexico with a free hit. They're kind of playing it slowly now. They've been under quite a bit of pressure. so taking a little breather to get ready there, and a quick turnover. Paredes, right side, looking inside, finds his man. Aguilera with a shot on goal, high rebound. Again, not dangerous, and collected. And Leon moving out. Ball ends up at the right side. Good recovery by Argentina. It's a bit better by Mexico, but there's a small area. He recovers. Good string of passing for Mexico. Baez looking up the field. Agustin lost the initial ball, but they move it on quickly. Vasquez looking for an advantage on a quick hit, but Kanabatu, the Malaysian umpire, says, no, go back. You have to be 5 meters away from the circle.
Yeah, and the umpires are really going to tighten up around that hash line there, especially in the 23. Looks like he's taking it outside the 23 now. And that must be why he sent it back, so that they can actually play it directly into the circle.
That's right. There's different rules in terms of how you can enter the circle, the shooting area, based on where your free hit starts outside the 23-meter line, the solid lines you see. You can go directly into the circle. Oh, there's a chance just outside the reach. Bobadilla, I think he saw that late. He might have dove and put his stick to it.
Yeah, I think he didn't think that was going to make it through. He almost hesitated entering the circle.
It's one of those things as a forward, though. You play against a strong team like Argentina, not many balls get through, but you've got to be ready when it does, because that might be your only chance of the game. There's an aerial ball just outside the reach of Paredes. Rolling substitutions. You can see Argentina doing that quite often. They get two or three players lined up, and they'll rotate three or four times during the game. A team like Mexico, perhaps less depth on the bench. Are they changing as much, Ali?
No, I definitely see Argentina shirts here moving at the 50. Mexico really relying on their core players, and Aguilar here, he's got to get tired soon, taking 1-on-4.
Well, yeah, he's doing a lot of running, and his hair is waving in behind him as he does it. Had a good sequence there with a save and a counterattack by Mexico, but if they lose the ball, they're being punished. The ball gets right back into their end quickly.
Yeah, this Argentinian line is definitely just very fast in their ball speed, their ball movement, their off-ball running. It makes it very, very hard to take advantage against them.
There you go, a loose pass, and Lopez jumps on it, and there he's off the right-hand side. A small mistake, an odd. It doesn't happen as often for the Argentinian players. A mistake there, and he loses the ball, but look at his teammates help him, and they all recover. Reverse stick pass, some space out. Aguilar turning inside and out. There we go. Here's a chance for Mexico now as he approaches the reverse stick shot. Potentially, he turns. Small slip, but Aguilar sweeps it. Oh, and it's just wide. Bobadilla with a couple of good moves, and the ball ends up with Aguilar. He just had enough time to get a shot on goal, but not enough meat on that shot.
No, it was a sweet pass, but I think just before that, Baez was hoping a hard ball was going to come through the circle there. He was quite unmarked.
Unmarked, but Argentina still managed to put enough pressure on him so that Aguilar couldn't see his teammate. I think Mexico's got a bit of their game legs now. They look like they're moving the ball a little better and playing with a bit more confidence.
Yeah, they definitely look a little bit more comfortable, not making as many errors, but they're still having trouble covering the full field with the ball speed that Argentina has.
Long ball off the end line. Mexico will restart. Good turn by Aguilar. Wow, some speed on him. It looks like he'll take on the whole Argentinian team. There's a slight errant pass, and Mateus Rey with a fantastic reverse stick interception there. There's a good turn. Manages to get it. Oh, the pass out to Villa just outside his reach. That looked like it would be a sure goal. Chicken dance. Sometimes they have these penalty corner specialists who do not much more, but Chicanan's able to do a great turn in the midfield and set up Vila just outside his reach on that sliding play.
And I'm not sure he would have made any mistake on that post.
No, those are the fun goals to score. I think all goals are fun to score.
As long as they go in the back of the net.
Here we go. Now we have six or seven Mexican players in towards the attacking zone. Vasquez with a quick turn on the top of the circle. They must take those free hits outside those hashed lines. And that one might have been one of the good chance there, because he would have picked up the ball protected, but he didn't manage to trap it. Argentina start up again. There's an aerial ball. Played above his shoulder. And there's our first penalty card of the game. That was intentionally playing the ball above his shoulder. You're not allowed to do that, so he'll sit off for 5 minutes. Caldecott giving the yellow card.
And there's a lot of evolution around that rule coming out now about the high stick. But I believe in this tournament that rule is not in effect.
Yeah, I think they've made the rule change at the top-level tournaments right now. This is a top-level tournament, but this is part of the World Cup cycle, so there's some experimental rules that are allowing you to play the ball above your stick, subject to danger, of course. If there had been two or three players in that area, that would not have been. That certainly would have been whistled down earlier. But in this tournament, those are still penalized as intentional, dangerous play.
And that makes it very difficult for Mexico to be one man down when they already feel like they're under quite a bit of pressure as is.
No, and it's you go from 11 to 10 men on the field. Doesn't seem like a huge difference, but you can see right now everybody but Vivaldi, the Argentinian keeper, is in the attacking zone. And that just forces you to back up a little bit. Feet are unprotected, and it's an easy penalty corner for Argentina. So this is the third penalty corner. They're 0 for 2. I think they're going to want to make sure that they get their penalty corner routine working. They've got tougher games coming up in the competition.
They're also rolling in quite a few of their sort of second line guys, so this might give some of them an opportunity to practice the special team plays.
Yeah, the teams always make sure they have their one of their top two penalty corner flickers on the pitch at a time. And right now, Sheikhan Dance is ready to line up here. A shot and a save, well done. Vasquez handling that well. And there's a errant reverse stick shot by Mazzilli. Surprised that wasn't called dangerous, but I guess it wasn't near anybody, and Mexico will take over. Well defended.
Yeah, and actually a really good job on the drag flick, because Ray actually mistrapped the stick stop there.
That's right, the ball doesn't need to be stopped dead, but when it's bouncy, it's hard to be able to collect it and throw it at goal. Maybe that's why it wasn't as much velocity as Sheikhan Dance would normally get, but Vasquez controlled it quite well.
But a great follow-up attempt after that. You can really see how the Argentine defense just collapses around any player in their defensive end. They have three people behind the ball right away, putting pressure on you.
Yeah, there's a school of thought. If you can take a forward and get his head down so he doesn't see what's happening, he can't make any effective plays. Here's a run. Argentina, 2-on-1. Chicken dance. Vargas making a great save there, coming out to put the pressure on. Mexico retaining possession. Are we going to see this game open up a little? It's great to see those long attacking plays. Another one. Cross and Ibarra gaining control of the circle. And that was quite easy for him, it seemed. He finds the foot of the Mexican captain, Hernandez, and we have another, the fourth penalty corner for Argentina.
Yeah, and just you can see they were in the Argentine defensive end, and right away, penalty corner in the other end. That's just that speed of Argentina that Mexico's having a tough time handling.
Yeah, and with such a large lead, Argentina's really not under any pressure. If the game is closer, a bit of the nerves settle in. But that's not the case today. There's a missed trap at the top of the circle. Argentina trying to manufacture something now. They do. Oh, and a beautiful goal. They play it out to the left, into the middle. A slight bobble. The ball comes up high, and it's batted into the open goal.
And that takes great eye-hand coordination and a good reaction time on the post there just to get the stick up and tap it towards goal. Very nice goal.
Absolutely. These teams have a set way places to be after a penalty corner breaks down like that. It happens way far too often for teams to not have a way to try to manufacture something afterwards. Argentina able to collect that and do something with it. And they're on the attack again. Here's a shot to the far post and another goal.
Chicken dance there with the reverse stick deflection, just popping it up into the top of the net. Just beautifully executed.
You're taught as a forward to shoot for the far post. If you're gonna hit to the near post and you miss it, nobody can help you. But if you hit to the far post, you'll always have a teammate there who could potentially put the ball in the net.
That's right. And if you're on the other end of it, stick on the ground or you won't be getting back on the field.
Yeah, that's where the coaches will yell at you quite a bit. So after a 10-minute spell where Mexico weren't playing all that badly and generating the odd chance at goal, Argentina comes back with three fairly quick goals. Ray in the middle. A hard drive into the circle. Saved by Vargas. Well, I thought initially it went off an Argentinian stick, but then a Mexican player's lower leg for another penalty corner.
So we're at 8-0, and I'm just looking down at the score sheet here, and Cayoni has three goals.
A hat trick for Cayoni. 50 seconds to play in the first half. There's the ball out to the top of the circle. Chicken dance. That is off the post. Tremendous power. It might have touched something along the way. We'll see if Mexico gets credited with the save for that. But the ball's back in the circle. Here's a reverse stick shot high and wide. Vargas had a good look at it, but it was well wide of the goal.
And now you see the difference between the clean stick stop there. Just how much power he got behind that ball.
Yeah, it looked like it might have been clean off the post or there might have been a touch along the way. Argentina did score on a penalty corner breakdown, but right now they're 0-4 on their penalty corners outside of that that great recovery from a missed penalty corner.
And I guess the coaches must be thinking that those two missed traps at the top of the circle are all the difference.
And that's the halftime horn. Argentina with a commanding lead in this match. Both teams will come to their benches and get some water and hear from their coaches. We'll be back with the second half coverage from Brampton very soon. Welcome back to Brampton, 2013 Men's Pan Am Cups. The second half is about to start. Mexico versus Argentina. Argentina with a commanding 8-0 leads. Four goals very early in the match. Within 4 minutes, then there was a bit of a break when Mexico got their feet, but Argentina responded with, ended up with four more before the end of the half. What are we going to see in the second half here out of Mexico, Ali? Anything that they can change in a short period of time?
Well, I know we saw in the first half a lot of action from Aguiar. He's like really their driving force up front, but some tightened up defense hopefully in the backfield, some fantastic saves from Vargas. I think they're just going to stick with those go-to people. Argentina obviously controlling most of the game, and their ball speed and transitions really catching Mexico.
Caglioni with three goals for Argentina. Mexico starts the match. They play it back, and Argentina push forward. They're likely going to play with some of their more reserve players, perhaps, but they've been rotating this whole game with free substitutions.
And that really is the beauty of this sport, the rolling subs.
Any number of substitutions as often as you wish. They only stop time if the goaltender gets substituted. Salas, reverse stick cross, slightly mishandled by Ortega. Be a long corner for Argentina. Lopez up there.
And that's such a great skill to have, a reverse stick low cross on the run. Gets you a lot of deflections at that far post.
Yeah, because you have to get your hand so close to the ground, and it's very difficult to do while you're running. Very easy to do while you're standing still. And that's that's the difference you'll see. The Mexicans will have to, their forwards will take a little longer, perhaps, to get their feet around in order to make that cross, where the Argentinian players are so fluid.
Yeah, and I think I'd argue that it's more effective almost as a pass up the left sideline or across, just like we saw there.
Yeah, it evolved over time. It used to be a very deceptive shot on goal, very hard to save, and now it's a more of a passing play. You're right. A touch by Argentina. Small little passes at the top of the circle, hoping to gain an advantage. Mexico defending well. Aguilar, who was very energetic in the first half for Mexico, continues at that pace. Doesn't manage to beat two Mexican players there, two Argentinian players. Here we go. Salas on the end line. Tries to shoot on goal. It's off the Mexican stick for a long corner on this end. There's a drag shot. Oh, and a save! Shot and save. Vargas coming out quickly. Ortiz collected the ball, turned, and shot on goal. Vargas steps out. Continued pressure. Free hit for Argentina. Ball goes back to Barrios. Barrios. He tries to cross it in. That's one of their weaker attempts at the Mexican penalty circle.
Well, we've seen that play quite a bit. They have, they have to respect the 5-meter rule there. So they just play a player back, give them a better angle. Quick ball back.
On his wrong foot, perhaps, as that ball's coming at them.
It's a bit of a hit and hope attempt, it seems, though, at this point.
Well, you have to wonder how the Argentinian team can motivate themselves very much. 8-0 up, and there's other games to play. So you definitely are trying to rest, but I don't think the coach will be, Carlos Ortega will be happy with them mentally resting as much as, doesn't mind them physically resting out there.
Yeah, as much as it is important to keep that lead, giving one goal up for a simple error is definitely not something they want to do. It doesn't show a sign of a team that's able to maintain that intensity throughout 70 minutes.
Argentina, of course, probably the favorite team in this tournament, although 4 years ago, in the 2009 Pan Am Cup, Canada, they lost actually to Canada in a semi-final match. So they want to kind of right that ship. They don't want to be going to a large tournament like World League Round 3 and winning a silver medal there, and then perhaps faltering in their continental tournament.
Yeah, and we were talking at the break there. It is very difficult to be a higher-ranked team and, like I said, maintain that intensity. But this is very good practice for Argentina, too, mentally, just to stay focused.
Go, 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 go. They're continuing to play positional pressure. Almost all their team in the Mexican half of the pitch. And as the sun moves overhead, it's going to get warmer here. There's a nice breeze for the players to keep them a bit cool.
Yeah, I don't think it was as hot as we were expecting, and the breeze definitely keeps the temperature nice, and it's always good to play in the sun.
Always is. Temperature in the Toronto area can range into the low 30s in August, and we've had some heat waves here recently. It has been up as high as 36, 37 degrees, but I don't think we're forecast for any of that this week. And you might think that some of these teams are used to warmer climates, but they still have to run hard out there. Here's Mexico. Bobadilla up the left side. He loses the ball. Ortiz plays this tidy little pass inside to Lucas Rey. He turns.
That was a very uncommon error there by the Argentinian defense. Just a little reverse stick pass back that went over the end line.
There you go, New Mexico trying to take advantage, but a slight error. Aguilar loses the ball, trying to get a penalty corner. Now Argentina is on the run. You can't spend any time talking to the umpires. Here's a shot on goal, the reverse stick. Not a pass this time, but a shot on goal. Lucas Vila puts it high and over the net. That's not worth 3 points. That's a free hit for Mexico.
That's right, but what an excellent ball through from the 50-yard line. Just stick to stick to the top of the circle. That's world-class hockey.
Yeah, so dangerous. Vila with an almost the same shot. Great save. Vargas kicking out that left foot, controlling the rebound. Argentina playing it back, looking for some space on the opposite side of the field. Payet puts it into the middle. There's a small mistake. Argentina, Aguilero looking for a obstruction perhaps, but that's not going to get called. Canabatu waves it on. Really, this could be a different game. There was 4 goals early. Vargas settled in, and he started making some quite good saves. He's made quite a number, and this could be a far closer game, but Argentina really put it away in that first 4 minutes.
Yeah, but you know what? Credit to Vargas, because he's made some great saves, like you said, and, you know, we're up in the tower, and I can hear him commanding his forwards from back there, and that's a sign of a really experienced goalkeeper to organize his defense line.
Vargas, the most experienced player on the Mexican team with 90 international matches. But the goaltender can see the whole pitch, obviously, and they've got to be able to direct their team and give them motivation along the way. I think Salas thought he might have had a right winger out there, and he played it out to the empty space. Captain Lucas Rey plays it. This is brother Mateus. Argentina up the right-hand side. A quick pass inside is errant. Agustin battling it. Loses the ball. Argentina not missing a step and crossing it out to the left side. Pelat looking again for the circle. That's a bit of a bobbly ball. I don't know why Vargas touched that one. That gives a chance to Vila. His reverse stick shot is saved.
I think Vila must practice a lot on his reverse stick. He's had 3 shots now, and that one was well struck right out of the air.
Well, that was a bouncy ball. You're right, Ali. That was not going to be easy to make contact, and he still managed to put that on goal. Ball goes for another long corner. Mexico in a bit of a bend but don't break mode right now. I don't think they're going to be wanting to play the rest of this half this tightly compact in defense.
You can see the frustration there. Mexico getting a little bit more physical, and they got to be careful not to give too much away out there.
No, it's like you said, it's tough playing with 10 men, and they'll be down to 10 men for the next 2 minutes with a green card being issued.
That's a tight range shot that you you don't normally see an Argentinian forward miss. Just struck a little wide of the left post.
From a narrow angle. There's a very quick turnaround there via a tackle, and he's immediately looking for his pass to Barrios. Mexico not managing to put more than one or two passes together before they turn the ball over. Mexican coach Sandoval Zuleta, he's told something to these players because it's a different tone to this second half. Mexico's defending better, but they don't have any positional advantage at this point.
No, and when they do get the possession, they look forward, and there's only one, maybe two green shirts up there, which makes it difficult when you still got 60 yards to go.
Yeah, that's the problem. They don't have a balanced position on the field. You can defend, and but you can't attack. But it's very difficult to be able to do both at once. You have to combine that with skill and experience before you can do that. Hernandez back on the pitch after his two-minute stint in the sin bin. Ortega unable to clear.
You can actually see the Mexican defenders getting a bit tired there following their forwards moving around there quickly. You can see a lot more of a swinging type of action trying to get the ball, showing a little bit of impatience and maybe a little lack of fitness there.
Yeah, well, Ortega looked like he just wanted to get rid of it rather than do something smart with it. And you're right, it's tired, it's frustration, because he had some time there, didn't he? Argentina, right side. Hard cross into the circle. That's off his teammate for a 16-yard hit.
Again, Argentina really looking to capitalize on those long, hard balls across from well outside the circle.
Well, when they play against some of the stronger teams in the tournament, they'll have to vary their attack. So they're trying some things that they probably don't need to do here against Mexico, but they must try to connect and figure out the field. You can see the ball's a bit bouncy, so they want to be able to play on, try all those various skills and techniques in order to get an advantage for their later games. Aguilar attacking, finds his teammate. Argentina requests some help from the umpire there, and Ibarra manages to get his call.
Almost a wall of blue defenders there as they enter the 25. Argentina not really giving them any room.
No, and what's interesting there is Ibarra is able to really be aggressive with his tackling, knowing that he's got teammates to back him up. Whereas the Mexico defenders, they are defending alone sometimes. So a small mistake is magnified, whereas Argentina is back up. So strength in numbers, both offensively and defensively. Is that fitness, Allie?
Yeah, I mean, a large part of that is fitness, and a big part of it is mentality, knowing that when the ball's behind you and you're a forward or midfielder, you got to get back.
Vargas out for with a great save against Mazzilli. Tidy little play by Mexico. Again, playing it forward to Aguilar, and it's just out of his reach. Aguilar running up the field, and the ball on the opposite side of where he was looking. Mazzilli gets the ball back. Quick counter. Mexico's still defending here, though. Aguilar unable to turn quickly. Caglione, 3 goals today.
Again, you see them trying to capitalize with that quick 5-meter pass, get right into the circle, and then they're probably just looking for a foot.
Yeah, there's no. If you're near the ball, there's no break for you, is there?
No, not
You've
at all.
You've got to be ready to go. I've talked to a number of umpires since the self-pass rule changes that in. There's zero break for there. They are constantly watching the game. There's no 2-second break after every whistle. Reverse stick cross. Large number of green shirts in the center of the pitch. Barreiros. Oh no, it's Lucas Rey plays it back. They have the confidence to play it back. Mexico doesn't have that luxury. They're always looking forward, and it means a quick free. Quite often means a turnover.
Yeah, I think going back also helps Argentina open up the field, hoping that Mexico will step out of their defensive end a little bit more, creating some space in behind.
Teams get crowded on one side of the pitch, so they'll move it back, and then left to right to look for an opening.
Space is one thing, but just their individual skills, their basics alone, regardless of the space, they seem to be able to capitalize.
Great skills there. How did that shot not go in?
Yeah, Chicken Dance, just a bit of a swing and miss as the ball bobbled through the air. But again, another great stick handling in the circle there with excellent reach there.
Yeah, but it has looked like he had lost it, pulls it back in, and is able to make that reverse take cross.
I think he has extra long arms or an extra long stick. He seems to have just that extra couple inches of reach.
Well, he certainly has some skills at that lengthy range. That's what 223 games for your country will do. And Paredes has been in multiple Olympic games. There's a goal for Argentina. That was actually a cross, and I think it got deflected by one of the Mexican defenders, and it ended up behind Vargas on the short side.
Yeah, but again, you see that ball from outside the circle, especially now with the own goal rule. I mean, it doesn't have to go off an attacking player anymore, so why not throw it towards goal and see what kind of havoc you can create? And there's a perfect example of how it can be successful.
Yeah, one of the rule changes that it surprised some people, in fact, is that now hockey has an own goal rule, and that means an attacking player does not have to touch the ball in the circle.
And the goalkeepers have to be ready to go at every minute.
So that was counted as an own goal. Argentina through the middle, attacking straight down the middle of the field. She can dance. Unable to collect that ball. Mexico start up again. They pass the Aguilera in the middle, but wow, is it crowded there. A quick tackle by Lucas Ray, and he's happy. He didn't get the call there. He fouled, but my God, he stops the play very quickly. And there it is, the same pattern again. Great turn by Aguilera. Great speed on him.
And I think that's why he's happy to step up on him the way he did in the first call there.
We saw that in the first half. That was Mexico's. This is their best chance to go. Aguilera was a shot. Goal!
That was an excellently struck ball on the reverse stick, just catching the goalkeeper just a little bit asleep there, and Argentina cannot be happy about that.
Well, no kidding. That might be the first real shot on goal. Vivaldi dove the right way, but the ball went underneath his arm. Aguilera really is able to turn it on in the middle. He's got a lot of energy. He's been doing most of the running for Mexico.
And I think that's why they want to be physical, stepping up on him, because he really is their go-to guy breaking out of their end. And you can see right there exactly why you need to be really tight on him and physical.
Yeah, it's interesting. These teams might only have one or two weapons, but Argentina, a team of their experience, has certainly been told that they've got to neutralize the one or two big weapons that a team like Mexico has. They're on another attack here. Renewed spirit after that goal.
And this game really is a game about momentum as well, right? So that one goal is going to give them that little, exactly like you said, a little bit of a lift. And now you see them on attack again.
That was a good pass to the top of the circle. That's often dangerous, but we have Pedraza collecting that ball into the circle. Very close chance for Orozco, but it was a good touch by the Argentinian defender to play the ball for a long corner. That's a great turn and a chance at goal. That's went to the short side. Pedraza looking for Vivaldi on the wrong foot. The ball might have been shot wide, but Vivaldi got his kicker on it.
I think he caught a bit of friction on the turf there on that shot.
It did look like that. It did look like it was a bit awkward for his left foot to make that save. It was definitely watering at halftime. Mexico, that ball put into the net after the whistle. Argentina is going to want to get the ball back into the Mexican end and hold some possession there.
Yeah, they're going to go back to what they do best, just maintaining possession, knocking the ball around a little bit.
Taglioni able to enter the circle nicely, playing the ball back. No teammate there. And just a little bit of pressure. Aguilera causes a mistake. Vasquez turns it over. He gets the ball back. Surrounded. Pass inside. Well done. Orozco running. Good give and go play by Vasquez, but there's three blue shirts. The dark blue eats up the ball. Belat fake the pass, touches the ball on. Argentina is able to enter the circle quite easily. That's an errant cross by Paredes. A little bit more committed defense. You're right, that goal is really motivated Mexico. They're now 2-on-2 attacking. Collision there as Mazzilli takes out the Mexican forward. They were hoping for a foul on that play, but the ball had moved on.
Yeah, and I think Mexico is continuing to argue, but the rest of the team is calling them back to their half-court press here. Argentina is happy to move on.
Yeah, it's interesting because they hadn't been defending very physically, but I think that's what they'll do in reaction to that goal. Just to say, listen, you might have scored, but you're really not part of this game. They're going to want to stamp their foot. They're a very skillful team, but they can play physical if they need to. Argentina attacking, right-hand side, up the end line. Goal for Argentina. Didn't look so dangerous. The angles are very poor, but he found a way to get the ball to the middle.
Not sure if that went off a Mexican defender's foot there or one of the Argentinian sticks. Try and get a look at the replay here.
There was two to three players in the middle, definitely one Argentinian player. We're not sure yet who came off of. We're going to get the stats here shortly and fill you in on that.
Regardless, it's an easy call for the umpire now that there's an own goal rule.
Yeah, it doesn't matter. If it's going off a defender and it's off a foot or a stick, it doesn't really matter. It's going to be a goal. Nine-1. Credited to Vasquez. There's a nifty little pass, a lob pass over the top. Beautiful skills. Mexico collects the ball here. Look at that control. Ibarra.
I think that was an important goal for Argentina. Getting the next one after Mexico scored was really important for them, for sure. Not to let another lapse happen.
Right, the game's over, and there's a dangerous play. Mazzilli probably took a little bit of a stick to the knuckles there.
You can see maybe a little bit more of that frustration from the Mexican defense line.
Yeah, that's what we talked about. That ball was in the air and dangerous, and I don't think the umpire got a good look at it. Here's Argentina attacking again. Paredes, good defending. Ortega getting in a little late. Gave him some space, then took it away. That's a good defensive tactic, isn't it? Lucas Rey, hard ball, just outside the reach.
Again, another long ball. I think he was just hoping Paredes would pop out of the circle there, but intentionally lifting the ball a little bit just to get through.
Well, you see so many flat stick tackles that the ball being 2-3 inches in the air is a very big advantage. Umpire playing advantage there. That could have been a corner, but they let Argentina play on. They're unable to create something from it. Leon to Aguilar, mistrapped. Mazzilli brings it back. Small pass to get the top of the circle for Argentina. They managed to get a penalty corner. They still had the ball. You think Matias Rey would have liked that advantage, or do you think they're happy to practice their penalty corner?
I think they're happy to practice their penalty corners from what we've seen. It's a good thing for them to be doing right now.
I think they were 0-for-5 in the first half. So they'll try to, with a post and a save on the line. So they might be executing okay. They're still trying to figure out the pitch. I've talked to a few of the players. They say the grain is slightly different on the north and south ends. Let's see if this is a bit smoother. A yacht behind the ball. His drag foot is wide. That was certainly executed better. The drag foot low to the glove side and wide of the goal. 0-for-6 Argentina on their penalty corners. Not a stat they'll be happy about. Aguilar underneath the aerial ball. He had position first, so they get the call.
Even threw his hand up there just so that he made clear to the umpires that he knew he was there first.
It's not a bad play. Make your intentions known. There's some good communication between the umpires and the players. They've had games together before, so they often are able to talk quite about the rules and things like that in the matches.
Well, and I think that's important. You want an umpire that's here for the players and to help the game move along. So that early communication's good.
Another chance and a goal for Mexico. Here we go. Bobadilla. That seemed to be come out of nowhere. They had some possession. Usually that doesn't amount to much because Argentina's been very focused with their tackling. But a small little space, and he threw it again to that low right-hand side. Second goal in that corner against Vivaldi. And so he's going to have to perhaps figure out how to keep himself in these games when they get out of hand and he doesn't get a lot of action. It's a difficult thing for a goaltender when you're playing for a dominant team.
Yeah, and they've passed it back here. I actually think they switched here. I think it's Bentold in goal here. That might be a switch that has made a little bit of a difference here in the backfield.
You're right, Ali. I missed that. That's Bentold in goal. That must have happened at halftime. Well, I'll apologize to Vivaldi then. He's there. He's been the number one keeper for Argentina for quite a while, and it's Bertold who has conceded the two goals in this half.
And Vivaldi with 141 caps, and Bertold with 34. Trying to give him a little bit of experience here.
Vivaldi's been the starting keeper for Argentina for a number of years.
So we've got just under 10 minutes here, and you can see a little bit of anxiety on both sides of the pitch here. Argentina obviously a little bit more comfortable, but Mexico kind of enjoying the ride right now.
Well, they've played this second half fairly even. Well, even in fact. 2-2 in the second half. Positionally not with an advantage. Argentina in the circle again. Good passing there. But it is Mexico clearing a little sloppy perhaps, but they got the job done. Vasquez gets a foul. Mexico starts up again. Two years ago, Mexico hosted the Pan American Games in Guadalajara. They have a number of AstroTurf pitches there. It's probably helped their program a bit, having a top-quality international pitch, as it'll help the Toronto region here, having this great facility here in Brampton.
Yeah, and especially for Ontario here, having this new pitch is only going to help hockey grow in the country. And
here's a through ball. Some good patience by Vila, but Vargas stays on his feet and chases him down. Mexico's trying to do a counterattack. They lose it. Lopez, long cross here on the end line. Paredes collects it, diving Mexican defending. Bobadilla, he's been running on both ends of the pitch, but here he is on the end line defending. Argentina, long corner. They're playing the small passing. Paredes looked like he was going to hit it. Oh, a little lost ball there.
Well, that is a sign of a very confident goalkeeper challenging that far out on the baseline. He knows he's got the baseline on his left side there. He's happy to come out and close the distance.
Oh, good ball there. Barreiros. Able to turn, the shot goes wide. Oh, it was a high stick. There you go.
Yeah, I think actually the initial shot was going wide, and then he came in and Aguero just tried to swing at it, but the stick was over his head. Good call by the umpire.
Argentina definitely with the advantage in the second half, but not on the scoreline. Too well. Well collected that ball. Mateus Rey, long ball through. You think you're playing offense when you're playing against Argentina, and they hit a 60-yard ball that all of a sudden puts you on your heels again.
Absolutely. I think that aerial was a good out for Mexico, but you can see just how fast that turns around, and well collected off the aerial.
Here's their counterattack. Vila again. Now going the other way, going to his left-hand side. He's got a little gap. Oh, what a fantastic finish. Lucas Vila.
What a brilliant finish, and again, goalkeeper coming out, getting a touch on the ball initially, but getting the feet around well to strike that ball. That was a fantastic finish.
Well, and I think that just split the hair of a couple of the Mexican defenders. There's no danger associated with a shot on goal. If you want to stand in there while one of these players is taking that reverse stick shot, you're brave.
Yeah, and you're not wearing a mask in free play.
Not at all. Argentina build their lead back to nine goals. Let's see. Mexico has responded to each one of the Argentinian goals in this half. Let's see if they can do it again. Aguilar, great speed. Burst past Tolini. He's got some help in the circle. Good spin and turn. Still has the ball, and it's finally cleared away by the third defender. Aguilar running on two players on his own, able to gain some advantage, but the third Argentinian defender cleaned up. Mexico, they are advancing up the field looking for another chance at goal here.
And I think he was actually looking to try and get a shot off, but maybe at that point, after you've come 20 yards, you're looking for a penalty corner when you get in the circle.
Yeah, he's an experienced enough player that he'll take the option that comes to him, but he almost created the space for a shot, which is very difficult when you're playing one-on-three. There's a turn, a bit of a waste opportunity. Oh, he did find a stick of the Argentinian player. Mexico retains possession in that offensive corner. Vasquez, Aguilar. He hit that high, didn't want to do that. Now let's see what the Argentinian counterattack looks like. Vila, the last goal scorer, he turns to the inside. He's 2-on-4, Mexico back in numbers. Aguilero. Got that advantage on that reverse stick side. Three Mexican players are forcing him. Great tackling. Always when you have numbers, it's easier to commit. It's a little bit of a bump in the middle.
And I think that's what they want to see more from Mexico, that patience on defense in the circle, not giving anything away, just keeping their stick nice and low. And
well, from my point of view, I like the way they put pressure on the ball carrier. You can mark people away from the ball, but if you put pressure on the ball carrier, it's offensive defense, and I like to see that. Counterattack. Vila in his red shoes passes it. There's a flip shot at goal. Vargas with the save. He's coming out well and staying confident on those plays. Oh, and a penalty corner.
I think Bobadilla was hoping that that was a clean tackle, but I think the umpire's calling it that he got his stick first.
Yeah,
big noise.
Yeah, and Bobadilla coming from the offensive area back, so you're often tackling from the back. You got to be very careful because you don't have good position. The forward doesn't know you're there, and it easily can be stick-on-stick contact. Argentina, seventh penalty corner, looking to convert their first one. Ball stopped, and the drag flick. This time, the glove side very low. The postman probably not very happy. He didn't make contact there. Vargas, a little wrong-footed. Tell me about the execution, Ali.
Yeah, I mean, I think he actually got that quite in his hook. It's almost like an indoor type type drag, and very hard, very deceptive, very difficult to save.
Yeah, there was. It was. He's able to create some deception at the top of the circle. That's why Vargas is moving right. But it was low on the ground, and I think the Mexican postman might save that on a lot of on other chances.
So we're at 12-2 now with less than 3 minutes to go.
Closing minutes, 12-2. Argentina commanding lead. Certainly will be leading the pool, and that's what everybody expected walking into this game. And they finish off again. That's more classic international field hockey goal. You would have seen that 20 years ago. Shake and dance with the ball across the goal. An easy, easy finish.
Definitely a textbook goal on the right side there. And you, as a defensive team, you need to know that those players are the ones they're looking for. And you just need to step up in front and maybe give them a bit of a bump. But the Argentina team's not going to make a mistake like that.
No, and there was lots of Mexican defenders there. I think it was just a little an absent-minded play by them. Oh, good strong positioning and a reverse stick shot. That's well defended. Very difficult. Part of the difficulty about that reverse stick shot is the defender cannot get into a good, safe position to make a tackle.
Yeah, but Murillo was right there with him, and I think he just got a stick on the ball just before, and you heard the big sound of the sticks clashing. So he got in there tight and protected his body.
Yeah, oddly enough, if you're far away, you're safe. If you're really in close, you're safe. But if you're in the middle, you're in trouble, aren't you?
Yeah, they call that no man's land.
Aguilar on the far post. Gains a free hit on the sideline against Salas. Closing minute and a half. Mexico respond with one more and leave this pitch with some sort of satisfaction of having played an even second half with Argentina. I think they need two to do that, actually, so that's not going to happen. Again, Mexico with some small passes, but unable to do much penetration on the left side. Argentina attacking now. Counterattack is what they're good at. Ah, Mexico does well to defend. Will he maintain possession? No, it's lost possession. Quick pass into the circle. Looking for a penalty corner there. Unable to get it.
And Barrero just trying to be physical there in the circle. Not quite getting away with it.
No, they have to position some. They have played some physical one-on-one, shoulder-to-shoulder play. They're going to need to do that against some of the stronger teams. Mexico speedily running out of their end. Pedraza. That's a good little pass to Agustin. He's looking for a penalty corner. Good footwork by Mateus Rey. He's not going to get tripped up too easily. There's a faked pass by Paredes to Nobel. Oh, great skills. Finds an open man with his red shoes. Aguilero shooting wide. Oh, that's off of Vargas. Great save. And that ends the game. Commanding result, 13-2 for Argentina. They go right to the top of their pool. Ali, any initial comments? Argentina, they got to be happy about that. Mexico, is there some sort of consolation for them in that second half?
Well, I mean, they really put in a great effort. And if you look at just the second half scores there, really tremendous amount of effort for them to get up in the attacking end and put away two goals against a world-class 10th-ranked team. I think that bodes well for them. The Mexican coaching staff obviously knowing what the result is going to be. So popping in two goals against a top 10 team in the world, I'd be pretty happy with that.
Yeah, they move on. These teams will play again tomorrow. It's Pool A matchups today. This morning, Argentina at the top of the pool. The teams are shaking hands. We had a schedule change earlier because some of the teams arrived late, Trinidad and Uruguay. So there's a break now before we find our second game of the day at 5 p.m. We'll be here back live at the Cassie Campbell Community Center here in Brampton, Ontario. Thank you very much for tuning in. Pan Am Hockey Federation is excited to have you online, and we look forward to seeing you for the rest of the Pan Am Cup. Thank you very much.